Hello everyone, today we are going to review Assertible.com. This is a product in the API testing space. It is similar to RunScope. And again, this product also has very good features. And I use this for my personal site monitoring. So this can be a good alternative for companies who are just getting started with API testing automation. It has very decent suite of features, and you can also see the list of companies that are using it and read through that. And again, one of the things that I always like with Assertible is their blog section. So if you go to their blog section, they provide wonderful strategies and also they keep users updated about what new feature they are adding. So it's a very good one. So I'm going to delve into this tool today. But before I start showing a demo for this tool, I would like to go back to my website and refer you to the few posts. My name is H.Thirukkumaran, and some of you might know about me. This is my site, H.Thirukkumaran.com, and I'm the author of the book, Learning Google BigQuery, and I work mostly in Google Cloud platform. So you can visit my site and stay in touch using my social channels. And I write about big data and cloud computing, e-commerce, software development, project management. These are the four topics that I write about. And I already posted a video about RunScope, and that has references to the resources that we will be using in this video. So the API that we are going to use today for testing is actually World Bank API. So you can click on this, and this is what I have done. So this is the World Bank API that we are going to set up some testing and monitoring with that. Okay. So let's go ahead and sign into the tool. Okay, you can sign up. There is a free trial. Okay, so if you go to the plans, you can see there is a free trial as well. The absolute as free plans get started today. So get started using a free plan to evaluate. Okay, and then you can choose whichever plan you want. This is here to try and assert to for free. Okay, so let me go ahead and log in. Okay, and then you'll get to look at that. Okay, so when you get when you log into this tool, and this will be the first screen that you'll be seeing saying enter a new web service. Okay, so the way Assertible works is slightly different from RunScope, where you first enter a test URL that you want to test, and then you can start to set up the various tests for those URL. Okay, and I think under the free tier for each service you can add only 10 URLs. Yeah, and there may be even a limitation under the number of tests under that. So but let's get started with this API. Okay, let me go ahead and make sure I chose the correct one. So maybe I will choose this one. So I'll choose this URL instead. This is about the GDP for India. So let's go ahead and paste it. Import URL. Okay. So again, yeah. So here they kind of guide us very easily. So we can see once it's done, it says, "Hey, do you want to do daily monitoring and run this test once saving?" So we want to do it, and then yes. So I give that. So create services and test. So let's wait for a few seconds. Okay, so now we are in this test. It brought us to this testing pipeline screen. Okay, so now before we do anything, okay, we want to set up a few things. So the first one is obviously get failure alerts. Okay, so if test failures happen, what should we do? Okay, click on that, and again they provide a beautiful integration with Slack, so you can go ahead and do it, or you can add your email notification and Zapier, okay, other plugin. So add your thing, and then you can create a hook saying whether you want to do it for when you want to actually run these tests. Is it when you deploy? Is it on schedules? Is it by trigger URL? Is it by dashboard? Okay, so I choose all. Okay, so I create this. Okay, and then what are the tests? So I just choose enable all tests, and then the initial test is obviously I will explain the tests, but the first basic test is you want to make sure that we have the URL being served correctly by the server. So right now we have this scheduled, so let's go back to tests. Now if you look here, it created the first default test where the result status should be 200. Okay, so that's what we are going to authenticate. So if you go to the assertions tab here, it will show that. So status code equals 200, that's the one. So then again, if you want to add a new assertion, you can start adding it. Okay, so this is the step. So for each test case, this is what we do. So the request, okay, and again, if you want to add some query parameters, query string parameters, and any headers for authentication, any body content, you can add all those here. Okay, and setups is something that you want to run before the test happens. Maybe you want to call some other URL so that the data gets into the database to show up, or clear a cache or something like that. And then teardown is after. So what should we do after the test has completed? Mostly cleanup. Clean up the data and clean up the machines. And assertions is where what you want to validate once you receive the response. And then settings is where you specify about the deployment integration, chat integration, email integration, schedules, and trigger URLs. Okay, so these are the things. Okay, so now let's add few more conditions to the assertions. Okay, and then see how it performs. Okay, so we are going to now add a new assertion. The first is the status code. The second one obviously is a very basic one that I do, which is JSON validation. Sometimes what I have experienced is the APIs, if they get an error, they return the status code as sometimes 200 with some message, so that with some error message. So that has happened sometimes. So we want to make sure the data that is returned by the server is a valid JSON. So this is the second one that I would add. And not rely on developers to properly give me that. So this is the second assertion. So let's go ahead and add a new assertion. Okay, so the next assertion we are going to add is this one, JSON path data. Okay, so I will edit it to show you, or maybe I'll delete and do it again. So I am going to add a new assertion. The assertion type is called JSON validation. Okay. So I want to make sure when I get the JSON, JSON path data. So when I get the JSON, I want to make sure in my result, I really get a result. Okay. So for this, if you look at this is the API response, and I want to make sure that the total number of records returned to me or for my query is greater than 0. So all I need to do is right click on this property and JSON view, copy path. Okay. And then come back here and paste it. Okay. So it pastes it. So and then what I want is greater than, and the value is 0. So this should be greater than 0. Okay. So I'm going to save some assertion. Okay. And then let's see what happens. So it executes everything, and then it passed this one as well. The total is 58. So that's why this test condition also passed. Okay. So this is the basic set of assertions that we keep adding. Okay, and then there is few more that we will add. And the most obvious one that we always look for after status code is actually the performance of the request. So response time, I should receive my response in less than 5 seconds. So this is again in milliseconds, so less than 5 seconds. Okay, so I'm gonna test that. Okay, and see what happens. Okay, so yes, it did. Okay, okay, so that's when we will see those summaries at the end, the executions. Okay, so now we have at least these four. So and we can try to keep this kind of a template and add a few more. Okay, again, you can go ahead and validate whatever you want in your JSON data using the JSON path. I would say the correct order in this would be check for status code, check for JSON validation, check for response time, and then go ahead and start adding your JSON path data validations. Okay, now let's go ahead and run this test and see what happens. Okay, so again, this is a very simple test using get operation on HTTP. Okay, I believe, yes, this is HTTP, not HTTPS. Okay, and then this is the World Bank URL domain name, and then this is the, and then I'm going to run the test. Okay, so it's running. Okay, and then let's see what happens. Okay. So the test passed, okay, so a total of 7 assessments, okay, all of them passed, okay, and then, and then let's go back to the overview section. So you can see this is one of the tests, and we had these results, okay. So if we expand this, we can see this, and then one of the things I liked about this is you can get a URL for this, and then you can start these tests manually. Okay, that's called the trigger URL. So let's go ahead and see what happens there. Okay, so I will run the test one more time, okay, and then let's go ahead and see what happens. So let's run this test one more time. It's running and it is passing. Okay, I think it's done. Okay, so this is where it is. Okay, so then it passed total of 7 assertions. Okay, and then once you click on this green bar, it will do it. So yeah, we had 4 types of tests. One is status code equals 20, that's passed. Okay, JSON well decent passed, and JSON path data passed, and response time. So this is how we see the results. Okay, again, if there is any failure, we get an email and other things. So this is a very good tool to get started. Again, if you want if you want to have more features, and your volume of testing is very high, go for a paid version of this tool. This is a fantastic one. I use it not just for API, I also use it to test my personal sites, so that availability of my personal sites. So if any of my pages go down, I get an alert immediately, and then I jump in to see what happens. Okay, and then finally coming to the settings. So this is the trigger URL. So if you look here, you can copy this URL, and then if you open it in the browser, it will automatically start the testing. And by default, you can see it is protected by an API token. Okay, and then it is this is what is happening now. Okay, so and then if you come back here, you would see that last execution to be triggered from this URL. So that's something I like. And also, again, if you want to protect this against misuse, you can always you can always add authentication. So you can add at least a basic authentication and give a key and a secret key to prevent misuse, or if you want to go with any authentication system like OAuth 1 or API based, you can do that as well. So that's something I always like about this. And then hooks and alerts, always make sure you set up hooks and alerts. And then again, I will add one more new hook saying if whenever the test completes, I want to send it to a different email ID. Yeah, so this is somebody who wants to monitor whether the test even ran. Okay, so that's what it is. And I am, as a very important, since I am busy, I wanted to get only the failure notification, not any successful notification. But you can assign this to somebody else, so that who has time to check all the mails, and this one to only to very important people like your manager, who receives only when it fails. Okay, so so that you can update them. So this is a new hook that you can add. So try those things. Okay, and then let me know your thoughts. Okay, and then if you need any more detailed presentation on this, I will definitely help you with this tool also if you need any help. And good luck with using Assertible. They have a fantastic support team as well. So Cody and Christopher, they are the founders of Assertible. If you have any questions, you chat with them here. Okay, and again, as you can see, they built a wonderful tool, and I like this because it's very simple. Again, it's also very, very developer focused, and it gives what I want within like first few steps. And the learning curve for this tool is also very small. You don't really need to spend more than a day to learn what it is, and as long as you know how to integrate your deployments, you are all done. Okay, and then coming back to the schedules, I think I covered it. So you can add schedules here. So this is a daily schedule. Okay, and you can even add a hourly schedule. Okay, so for the environments, okay, and then it will start. And if you pay for premium, you can write run your test every minute, every 5 minutes, every 15 minutes also. Okay, so try to use this. Okay, so and it's they give you first month free, so that would also be good. So try it out, okay, and then let me know your feedback, or if you need any help, reach out to me or Cody and Christopher in Assertible. Good luck.